So we're down in mid-Shropshire today. We're in a field of potatoes and we're with David Watoff from Metos UK. David, just tell us a little bit about yourself and what you do at Metos.
So at Metos we distribute the Pezzle Instruments weather stations. Pezzle Instruments have been integrating with John Deere for the last 3 years, working closely with Rear Valley Tractors, and it's really great to be here.
Cool. And we're in the field with this new type of low-cost weather station. Just tell us a little bit about it and some of the sensors as well we can add to it.
Yeah, so weather stations traditionally have been something which people have put on into farmyards and use that data for fields. What we've launched here is our low rain set of weather stations, which allows you just to put a weather station at a good price straight in the field. This particular one records rain, temperature, humidity, but also crucially for a crop of potatoes, we're also measuring soil moisture.
So how's the soil moisture measured?
So we've got a very simple system, which is a forked soil moisture probe, which goes into the potato the ridge, and it gives the volumetric water content. So typically on a field like this, you'll be looking for sort of 12 to 15% soil moisture on a typical day.
Cool. And it's all viewable on an app on your phone?
Yeah, so all of the data is viewable on an app on your phone. You can share your login details with your agronomist so he can see when he's walking the field separate to yourself how the soil moisture is going. And all of the data is available on our web portal as well.
And it logs data every 15?
Yep, it logs data every 15 minutes. And then you can set it how frequently that it sends the data back. So typically in this situation, this is logging every 15 minutes and every hour you're getting an update.
I suppose it being low cost, yeah, it's effectively you could have these dotted around the entire farm location, all your different fields.
Well, this give you this is the real secret to this, because traditionally to put a soil moisture probe into a field of potatoes, you'd be talking well over £1,000, and that would only be doing your soil moisture. For this, we're doing our for £650. We've got rain, temperature, humidity, and the soil moisture, and having the additional sensors also allows us to monitor things like blight.
Yeah, because we do disease forecasting and, you know, predicting or to see when the disease is going to occur. And
yeah, completely that. You know, I mean, farmers will be typically looking to spray their fields every 7 to 14 days. If we can help the farmers make better decisions by understanding the impact of the weather, then having a in-field sensor is a great place to start.
Yeah, and you also do a range of sensors. Obviously, you do the higher level sensors as well. So you do stuff like evapotranspiration and solar radiation.
Pezzle Instruments have been making weather stations for 35 years, and we have an extensive range of products. And so, indeed, we can have a big weather station which will do all of the main calculations which you were talking about.
Yeah, and it also links to my John Deere as well, doesn't it? The operation centre.
Yep.
You can view your data in there and have a link to the Pezzle site.
And it works really nicely because on your operations page, where you can see your tractors, you can also see where your weather station is.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
When you're planning in the morning and you're using the desktop of the operations centre, you can click on the weather station, you can see what the soil moisture is, you can see what the temperature is at that particular field, and you can really get some work planning done better by using this type of equipment.
And suppose with the disease forecasting, it's also about optimising the pesticide usage. So only applying when it's the plant's going to use it the most.
Yeah, very much so.
And protect the most.
But I find the best relationship is with the farmer, the agronomist, and the weather station, when the three of them collectively looking at the data.
Because
there's lots of sort of very local impacts which mean, you know, you might not be able to get on because the soil's so wet, and that might delay your timing. But understanding the optimum time, just with a good value, low cost sensor system in the field, really does help make decisions better.
Cool. Well, thanks for your time, David. And if you've got any questions or want further information, then please get in touch.
That's great. Thank you.